Hello there and welcome back to CFO Conversations. I'm your host, Paula Kensington, and always a great pleasure to have Sue next to me in the studio. Sue, we're going to talk today about the imposter syndrome and something that if you haven't experienced it, perhaps you haven't looked deep enough with inside, because I think we all do suffer at some stage with this feeling, male or female. And Sue, what's your thoughts on what it is and how we're going to start thinking about
dealing? Imposter syndrome generally affects people who are generally high achieving. And it's this feeling that we're going to be found out to be a fraud. So this feeling that we actually don't deserve the success that we have, and that we think, you know, it's that feeling when you've started a new job and you go, oh my God, they're going to find me out and somebody's going to kick me out of this role. So the research I've read actually suggests that up to 70% of people will experience it at some point in their careers. And there are a number of high profile individuals, both male and female, who have said they've experienced it. The research does also show that if you are in a minority group, you are more likely to experience it, which is why I think it has become associated more with women in senior leadership roles, because they are in the minority at the leadership levels. However, it can affect everybody. And I think actually one of the ways of managing it is understanding that it's normal to have doubts sometimes about our capabilities and what we're doing there. And interestingly, as you say, if you've never had some self-doubts, there's something going on there as well.
Yeah, I haven't looked deep enough. I mean, perhaps some of the tips that I've had in my career is actually writing things down. So in an earlier conversation, we were talking about reflection, and it's so powerful to reflect. And often when we're in a period of reflection, we can write down some things that we know that we're good at and some things that we really enjoy doing. And often if you actually write them down for me and put them into my sort of studio office area, I can recall that and I can see that I wrote that at a period of time. And, you know, so when you're not feeling as confident as Boyd, you know, we can read that and know that that is true. We wrote that.
Yeah, that's great. I tell people that, we all have two voices in our heads, the inner critic and the inner champion. And the inner critic is that voice that says, you're not good enough, you can't do this, you'll never be able to do this. And we have to accept that that's a thought in our head. It's not reality. And one of my clients has actually done exactly the same as you were suggesting. He set up what he called a Kudos File, which I loved, which was about collecting those pieces of positive feedback. If they were verbal, it was writing them down, or if they're emails, cutting and pasting and saving somewhere. And they can be great, one, for performance review time, but also for when we're struggling to come to terms with a new concept or a new role, to remind ourselves of the inner champion that says, actually, I've got this, I can do this.
And I think, like another conversation we've had about leadership being a practice, this is a practice as well. This is continually building that muscle that says we are good enough. And an exercise I did a couple of weeks ago was closing the door on self-doubt and opening the door on just doing, like taking action, you know, trumps all the time. Just continually take action every day. Really helps with that imposter syndrome, I think.
Yeah, I always say that as well. You need action to move you forward and build your confidence. So the example I give people is you can't learn to ride a bike and become a great cyclist purely by thinking and talking about it. You have to get on the bike. And we all remember learning to ride a bike as a kid with training wheels or, you know, mum or dad holding the bike. But we have to do it. We can't actually get any better until we put ourselves out there, put ourselves at risk, and build the confidence in that. And I think that is a huge part of learning to cope with our imposter syndrome, as well as the third one for me is building a support network, having people to talk to who understand where we're at, who can empathize and also support us and say, that's okay, we've got your back. We're going to help you get through this next stage.
Yeah, definitely having that trusted inner circle. And you know, I think there's maybe five or six people in there that you really let into the inner sanctum of who you are and how you really feel about some things. That really helps. So if you haven't got an inner circle, then definitely try and build one. And just it's a daily practice, right? So just keep trying. So thanks, Sue. That's a great one.
Great.